We have Tezos, hosted by Mr. David Davian, and we are going to be looking at this one just in general, as no time frames were given. Anyways, first thing that kind of sticks out to me, all major movement averages bullish right here, major volume in that last spike to the upside above the 200 simple, lovely. And while it is getting a bit of a pullback, which is to be expected, I would be looking for a bounce probably somewhere around about 435 or so. See if that lines up with the short-term time frames. It does. That is exactly in line with the 4-hour 21 and the 4-hour 10 simple within that region. So a little bit of a short-term pullback. As you can see right here, volatility did spike all the way up to 100 percentile on BBWP. So, you know, pullback to be expected right there. Sideways and down on this one. But long term, I actually do kind of like this, especially as long as it's closing daily totals above about 413 and a half specifically. Momentum charts over here. Let's see. It's USD. What do we see right here? I guess Finex actually is one to go to. That's a weekly, that's not relevant towards what we're talking about. Daily is downside angled as long as below 490. So again, best case scenario for short term and medium term, I would be looking for sideways and down. 4-hour actually freshly twisting down, so this is a little bit more nasty right there. Do not want to see it fail below about 432, about 432 to 433 or so. If you do see it fail below there, I would be looking for an extension of the downside move to about 395 and look for a bounce there. And at that point, I believe that coincides, that does start to destroy the daily look on this one. So I would actually start to look for this one to probably cough up the majority of this rally if that happens. But until then, you know, I still do like the daily. I expect that the 5-day is okay in this case. 3-day, very, very good closure right there as well. You know, I do think that it'll bounce off that level and probably trade sideways and up from there, but I don't think that you're going to be seeing anything super interesting like today or tomorrow, for that example, maybe like early September, if anything. Hourly down as well. So short-term down, medium-term sideways, if you do want to be bullish, and then hope for the upside resolution on there, and hopefully that was helpful, sir. Nice.